Hello friends, welcome back. In previous lecture we have seen how can we create directories. In this lecture we are going to see how can we remove files and directories. So to remove a file we are going to use a command called rm. Rm nothing but remove. Let's go and remove a file. This is my Linux system where I have a directory and I have files as well. Before executing other commands, I am going to show you one more command, that is tree. Okay, tree is the simple command which will tell you what is your directory structure. By default it may not be available. If it is not available, we can install this command. Okay, it is not available. I am installing it. How we have installed our nano? M install tree minus y. Okay, I have installed. Clear the screen. Ls, these are the files, right? And if I give tree, you can see here. So this is the file and these all are files, and we have directory 1. Within the directory 1 we have directory 2, 3, 4. Okay, you can see here this symbol. So tree is the one of the easiest command which will tell you how the directory structure has been created. Now I would like to delete a file. I can delete my file by using a command called rm. Okay, rm followed by file name. So if I execute this one, do you want to remove this file? Yes, of course I want to remove it. I can give y nothing but yes, and if I do ls, now you cannot see the file one. Again I can execute just a tree, there is no file one. So by using rm command we can remove a file. I can still remove multiple files by using rm command. File 2 and file 3, like this you can give any number of files. Yes, I want to remove. Yes, I want to remove. So it is asking us to confirmation to remove file or not. If you don't want to get a confirmation, we have a flag called F. F stands for force. So you can remove a file forcefully. If I check tree again, you can see only you have dir1 and file 4 and remaining two default files. Okay, now I want to remove the file 4 and it should not ask for the confirmation. Then I can use the rm minus f. F stands for force and file 4. Now you can see here it didn't ask me that do you really want to delete this file or not. And if I do again tree, you can see only you have directory structure which you have created. Alright, so by using rm command we can remove our files. Now I would like to delete my directory as well. Okay, so let's go and delete our directory. So to delete a directory we are going to use the rmdir command. How we use mkdir? Mkdir nothing but make directory. Similar way rmdir remove directory. So I am giving rmdir followed by my directory. We'll see what output we are going to get with this command. And it won't mind if you have more spaces, okay? But in Linux, it is case sensitive. You should not give the caps T, okay? So you can see here what it is saying. Rmdir failed to remove dir1. Directory is not empty. It is saying that I am trying to remove this directory, but this directory contains some files or directories. So rmdir command will work only on the directory which is empty. Nothing but if I check inside this directory, it should be empty. Otherwise, it cannot able to delete. So I cannot delete dir1. Before deleting dir1, I need to delete these directories, right? Then only I can remove. So in that case, what I can do? I can go to dir1 to go inside cd dir1 and tree. If I do, you have three directories, or even ls minus l also you can do. These three are empty directories. Now I can remove these directories by using rmdir command. So rmdir dir2 dir3 dir4. Okay, like this I can remove. But I don't want to make this entire directory empty. That's why I am removing only dir2. Just to show you that if directory is empty, we can able to remove the directory. So you can see here, and ls, if I do, I have removed the dir2, or ls minus l I can say. dir2 I have removed. Now we have dir3 and dir4. Alright, So here we are using ls minus l. Instead of ls minus l, you just use the ll command. Both will give the same output. LL also similar to the ls minus l command. Alright, now it is only three directories. I can remove these directories and go back and delete the dir one. But if you have hundreds of files and directories, how can you remove these files or directories? That is where we have one more command, okay? And yeah, by the way, cd dot dot nothing but you will come out from your directory. So earlier I was inside my dir1, right? Now I came out from the dir1. So cd dot dot nothing but go to the parent directory. I think I have executed this command in previous lectures also. I missed to explain it. Anyway, we are going to see that one in later. So if I check my pwd, I am under root. If I do ls, now you can see here you have dir1, and tree if I do, you can see within the dir1 we still have two more directories. So I cannot execute rmdir dir1 because it is still not empty. If that is the case, we can use a command rm minus f. Okay, if you do remember, we used this command to remove our files. Okay, same command we can use to remove directories also, but we need to add one more flag, that is minus r. R stands for recursive. So I am saying that recursively delete all the content within the directory. R stands for recursive, F stands for forcefully. Forcefully remove either it is a file or directory, remove entire directory structure. If I give dir1, it is going to delete it. Okay, but as I said earlier, instead of using different flags, we can combine these two, that is rm minus rf we can do. So execute the rm minus rf dir1. Now if you see here, there is no directory and it is clean. Whatever files or directories we have created, everything we have removed. Okay, so this is how we can use the rm command. One last useful command which I am going to show you and also dangerous, that is rm minus rf star. So this is very dangerous command. Whenever you are executing rm command, please be cautious. There is no recycle bin in Linux. If you are deleting something, it's deleted. There is no way to recover that file. That's why backup is the most important or necessary stuff in Linux environment. In Windows, if you delete something, you can go and retrieve at least from recycle bin. Here, there is no such kind of option. So be cautious while executing rm command, especially rm minus rf star. Okay, so star is a wildcard character, which means equal to any file or any directory. If you want to delete entire structure or entire folder, if you want to delete 100 files or directories and subdirectories are there, you want to delete entire stuff, then you can use the rm minus rf command. But please cautious while executing this command. We may use this command in the later session. For now, we are not executing because I am cautious and I don't have any files to delete at this moment. So I am stopping over here. That's all for this video. Again, see you in the next video.